Time is definitely one of my love languages, and he travels a lot, so we really have to be careful to make sure we come together and spend time together. You know, before kids, if he said, I'm going to the post office, I'd say, wait, I'm coming with you. You know, anywhere you go, I'll go.
Yes.
Obviously, that's not realistic now, so we have to really be careful to carve out that time and not give our leftovers to each other.
Bill and Pam, talk about red hot monogamy. My goodness. Well, there's no time like the present. Can we take a quick break here?
Hold on there, Romeo. We have guests.
Oh, there are guests here. We got Mike and Diane and Dan and Danielle. And
this is our home. We're still here. Okay.
Mike's got his red hot jacket on. That's good.
Okay, I love the name of Bill and Pam's book, Red Hot Monogamy, because you know what? Hollywood has tried to brainwash us into thinking that once you get married, that you can't have like that sizzle in your love life. Exactly, that it has to be play in the field before you can find that. No. You can have that in your marriage, even in 34 years of marriage. You just have to make time. You have to be deliberate. It can be done.
And that time is important.
Exactly.
For guys, things always revolve back to sports. So for me, Nick Saban is arguably the best college football coach of the new millennium, of this era. And he has this thing about process, right? Process. And what I learned is I'm going to need more process in my life, right? I've got to make sure that at 10, 20 minutes a day, I can honor that once a week, and then that time, that monthly time, that 8 to 12. I'm going to try to do this. This is a challenge for me. And once a year, getting away, T-I-M-E, I'm all over it. Yes.
It's important. Mm-hmm. Now, you guys still have young kids in
we
the home.
Do.
So that would be extra.
So have
challenge.
You done the piggy bank thing?
Duly noted, Pam. But I mean, time is definitely one of my love languages, and he travels a lot, so we really have to be careful to make sure we come together and spend time together. You know, before kids, if he said, I'm going to the post office, I'd say, wait, I'm coming with you. Anywhere you go, I'll go.
Yeah. Yes.
Obviously, that's not realistic now, so we have to really be careful to carve out that time and not give our leftovers to each other, but be fresh and ready.
Not give our leftovers to each other.
There's different seasons, and we just entered a season where all our kids were at school during the day, so we've been able to do some day dates and stuff like that, and carve out some time during the day, and all that good stuff.
Whatever works, right?
Yeah.
You gotta make it work.
Exactly. That's what has to happen, because you want to become a better us, but you got to have those intimate moments as well.
T-I-M-E. I like where Bill was saying that he's negotiated it down to just 10 to 20 minutes. Yeah, she wanted 2 hours of 90 minutes of talking. But hey guys, I negotiated it down for you 10 to 20.
I wouldn't have any input to that. I think 10 minutes is a little too short. Negotiate it back up a little.
But at least they're getting it in, right?
That's right.
They're getting it in.
Right.
Start there.
That's right.
Yeah.
It sounds like membership has its privileges, guys. So maybe we will negotiate if necessary, yes.
Talking about the different seasons of life, we're in a season of life now where we're basically empty nesters. Our kids are adults, but then we see couples who are in, say, your season of life, who actually need to have some help carving out that time. So actually, in 2 weeks, we are driving down to Indiana, and we're going to give our daughter and son-in-law a whole week away. We are going to stay with their kids, our two grandkids, 5 and a half and 2 years old.
Wow.
And Andrea and Jason are just going to go away. We said, just go. Go. Don't even take your phones. Just go.
They're taking the E in time and escaping. And
So couples in our generation, maybe we can invest into those younger couples that need some extra help in doing that. Let that be a challenge to you if you're like us. So actually, this has been a good conversation, but you want to stay tuned, because when we come back, it's going to be just the girls talking, and we're going to talk about red hot monogamy. Just the girls. Stay with it.
The tea is hot.
That's right.
I start to think about my husband and all the things I love about him. I start to think about the times that we laugh together, and the times that he's really kind to me, and I just set myself up emotionally to feel close to him, so that when he goes, hey baby, all right, I'm ready to go.